Hi everyone, Dr. Wayne Saltsman, geriatrician and elected member of the Burlington Board of Health, coming to you once again to help you stay informed, feel supported, and be prepared around the COVID-19 pandemic. It's an ongoing saga, as we know. I have some things to share, and it's hard for me to believe that this is the 11th time that I have shared some thoughts with you. So first the numbers, and I really just want to focus on Massachusetts today. It's really the tale of two cities, so to speak. We know that we have greatly reduced hospitalizations, folks with COVID-19 in the hospital. We know that we've done over 420,000 COVID-19 tests, and we have information that shows that we have done over 14,000 tests in a day. On the flip side, we still have a significant number of deaths every day in Massachusetts, 174 deaths between the past 2 days. Majority of those deaths are in the skilled nursing setting. And we do have still over 1,600 reported cases of COVID-19 a day. So we're still in the thick of it. And unfortunately, there is ongoing confusion about how long we'll be in the thick of it and what we can do to get out of this COVID-19 time, especially around a vaccine. And you have all heard government officials and healthcare officials make their statements. And frankly, even I get confused at times. But from what I read and from what I understand as a physician, I do believe that a vaccine is going to be imperative. It's going to be coming. We all wish it could happen a little bit sooner. It will be coming, but I do believe that we do need some sort of medical intervention. I don't believe, as I've heard some say, that this is going to go away on its own. I don't think that's indeed the case. So between what medical experts can do and what we can do, we will help to fight COVID-19. A very interesting study came out recently which showed that just talking can spread the virus through very, very small particles that can stay within the area around us for up to 14 minutes. That's scary, but it offers some insights into why some folks who are without symptoms are able to spread the disease and create symptoms in others. But it also helps us understand how important masks are in just helping to limit the possibility of any virus being exposed to other individuals. So I think that's crucial. So May 18th is going to be a transforming day. We've heard Governor Baker talk about the reopening plan. Our leaders continue to juggle economics and healthcare, and obviously as a physician, I'm concerned about healthcare of our community, but as a Board of Health member, I'm also concerned about making sure that our business owners are supported that the Board of Health is addressing their needs too. I would just urge for ongoing patience and support as we all work through this together. And even as we think about healthcare resuming back to some sort of normalcy or what will be the new norm, it makes me think again that, at the end of the day, with Leahy Hospital and Medical Center in our backyard, we are a medical community. While we have seen the frustrations expressed by a number of folks just through this pandemic, I think that the town of Burlington is strong. We're all good citizens in support of each other. And we will be a model for others as we all recover from COVID-19. So as always, what can we do now? And actually, I shouldn't even have to remind anyone in this part of the segment about what to do. But it is my mantra, and I feel a responsibility to remind all of us. Hand washing. Clean surfaces that are commonly used with just household cleaners. Protect your sneeze and your cough. Isolate yourself if you're ill. Wear a mask out in public. Social distancing, crucial. I am concerned about what I have seen across the country with regard to folks who are not taking these steps seriously, especially masks and social distancing. And I really do fear that if we aren't good citizens and if we aren't protectors of our own community, then we will be seeing this issue again. Also, be cautious with your travel. As you transcend into New Hampshire or into Maine, you see signs that talk about quarantine. If you are going to those areas, just be responsible. Be responsible, be that Massachusetts citizen that you are, and understand that social distancing and masks are still crucial in those areas. I would offer again that for any questions and concerns or issues, refer to the website burlington.org. There's a public health alert tab you can click on that gives you all the latest information. Reach out to the Board of Health for any questions or concerns. We want to help. We want to be as much of a source of information as possible. And of course, if you know an older adult who would benefit from a phone call, please make the call. We're all in this together. Stay safe and be well.